många länder har sin territorialgräns i Östersjön.
Vi har ett väldigt stort område och har varit övervakade. Det gör vi varje dag, året runt, dygnet runt.
Att kunna försvara sig ute på öppet hav är fundamentalt för att kunna lösa ut helhetsuppgiften och att hålla ett lands försvar.
Having previously submerged ourselves in its depths, we're now turning our attention to the challenges of maintaining security on the surface of the Baltic Sea. This includes protecting vital transport and communication routes, safeguarding civilian vessels, and ensuring uninterrupted maritime operations, many of which are absolutely crucial to our everyday lives. There's more going on than first meets the eye. Many illicit activities are simultaneously carried out in the same space, made more complicated by international waters and national borders. This is Shielding the Baltic Sea on the Surface, Part 1.
Maritime crime encompasses a whole lot of issues such as drug trafficking, human trafficking, piracy. The high seas are an ungoverned and in some parts ungovernable space. They are at the same time a public good of mankind. There's no single institution responsible for the high seas, and individuals or organizations or cartels seek to use that space to create uncertainty, to use it for their own personal and financial and criminal gain.
Varje dygn så är det ungefär 4000 fartygsrörelser runt våra kustlinjer. Vi ska ha kontroll över ytan. Vi ska ha en normal bild att kunna bedöma. Om den normalbilden devierar, då anpassar vi beredskapen utifrån våra behov.
It was the summer of 2009 and the Maltese flagged vessel, the Arctic Sea, was making its way off the coast of Öland when disaster struck. The ship was hijacked by a group of pirates who swiftly boarded the vessel and shut down its AIS automatic navigation system, allowing them to slip away undetected. A staggering ransom demand of $1.5 million was made, with the lives of the crew hanging in the balance. A massive search and rescue mission was launched, with authorities racing against the clock to locate the missing vessel. Weeks later, the Arctic Sea was discovered off the coast of Cape Verde, where the crew could finally be rescued. The possibility of a similar hijacking once again taking place in the Baltic Sea remains. Collaborative efforts, intelligence sharing, and joint exercises play a crucial role in monitoring and securing the extensive maritime landscape of the Baltic Sea. Additionally, advanced defense technologies are employed to ensure the security of the open sea. These, in particular, have come a long way since 2009.
Vi har utvecklat radarsystem väldigt länge. Våra radarsystem är väl anpassade för att kunna operera i en öppet havmiljö. De är multimission, vilket betyder att de är uppgraderade med mjukvara. Och då kan du också anpassa dem för den operationen som du behöver lösa ut. Vi har vidareutvecklat dem över tid, vilket gör att de är väldigt väl anpassade för att möta de potentiella hoten som finns ute i Östersjön.
There's a tendency to talk a lot about disruptive technologies, and I think the maritime domain is the penultimate area for disruptive technologies. Think about the transition from sail ships to steamships. Think about nuclear power. Think about all the radar sensors capabilities that we have today, and navies always adapt. These technologies have always played a very important role. They literally keep people afloat at sea, they keep them safe, so they rely on functioning and effective capabilities much more than individuals on land or in the armies. Navies are therefore a very cost-intensive but also worthwhile investment to have.
The Baltic Sea presents many challenges, and obtaining a real-time overview is a challenging yet necessary task, as a hostile party is likely to use these circumstances to their advantage should they decide to strike. As conflicts become more multi-layered, the need for quick and decisive action increases.
Även om du opererar ute på öppet hav så kan det vara så att hotet kommer från luften eller under vattnet. Och det betyder att ett fartyg kan ha en otroligt komplex uppgift att lösa ut. Där gäller det att ha en helhetsförmåga som är helt relevant Du behöver också kunna ha interoperabilitet med andra typer av system för att kunna lösa ut en uppgift där du behöver support.
To address increasingly sophisticated challenges posed by hybrid threats, naval forces rely on advanced technologies, such as advanced combat management systems, to identify and respond to potential threats quickly and efficiently. The engine room is often considered the heart of a ship, while its cognitive counterpart resides in the CMS. This central space is with screens and operator consoles that facilitates the ship's access to sensors, radars, sonars, weapons systems, and other critical components. All decisions must be made simultaneously across air, land, and sea domains, and international collaboration is crucial.
Vi har byggt system över många årtionden. Vi har byggt mycket kunskap och vi har en stor erfarenhet som bidrar till att vi idag kan leverera relevant förmåga till en slutanvändare så att den kan lösa sin uppgift vid rätt tidpunkt baserat på rätt information.
Despite advanced equipment, certain activities in the Baltic Sea like smuggling, environmental threats, aggression or maritime rescue operations can go unnoticed. Monitoring these vast sea areas is a complex task that requires substantial resources. Through technological innovation and improved surveillance equipment, we can expand our monitoring capabilities, creating time to act and respond to threats. Failing to ensure safety on the Baltic Sea can have dire consequences that affect our geopolitics, trade, supply chains, humanitarian efforts, and shipping costs. Ultimately impacting our way of life. Therefore, remaining at the forefront of technology is now more critical than ever. With unrest brewing seemingly everywhere, we cannot afford to neglect our maritime defences. That includes all of us, which is why we will examine exactly what needs to be done in the next episode of Shielding the Baltic Sea.